just prior to the time that they crawled through that hatchway into the Soyuz spacecraft to begin the process of closing the hatch. That hatch closure occurring at 4:30 p.m. Central Time.
The main and backup power supply. The commands have been sent.
Again, this trio of crew members wrapping up 164 days in space, 162 days aboard the International Space Station, having launched from the Baikonur Cosmodrome back on April 5th, docking to the Poisk module of the International Space Station on April 7th.
The PO2 is 144 at this time. Okay, it's going to take a while. Okay, now proceed to the leak check for the transfer hatches.
Departure farewells here in the lab. That tape came down successfully?
Yes, it did. And we really appreciated it, and it was very, very nice.
Okay, great. We'll put that tape in the reuse bag then.
Okay, sounds good.
Again, you're looking at video that was recorded just a few minutes ago by Sergei Volkov, who remains on board the International Space Station with Mike Fossum and Satoshi Furukawa, as Samokutiaev, the Soyuz commander on the right, Ron Garan in the middle, Barasenka on the left. One final opportunity to say goodbye to their colleagues before the hatches were closed at 4:30 p.m. Central Time about 10 minutes ago. In the first step leading to the undocking of the Soyuz, that will take place just under 3 hours from now at 7:38 p.m. Central Time. Samokutiaev there wiping down the outer ring to the hatch between the Soyuz spacecraft and the Poisk module to make sure no particles of debris are present that could interfere with a clean undocking of the Soyuz spacecraft.
The off-nominal situations book is prepared. Okay. Let's go ahead and start then and continue talking to us, please. Okay. The KVD is in the closed position. KKT valve is being put in the open position. Install the KKD to the open position. The KVD is closed. Moving, translating to the SR.
Закрывай люк САБО.
Closing the SABO hatch. The SABO hatch open indicator is off.
Люк закрыт.
Hatch is closed.
Он... Скафан. Андрей, запиши давление БО.
Андрей, please write down the BO pressure. 8. 46 millimeters MCC Moscow, the SABO hatch is closed, the LED is not on, and we wrote down the pressure.
And with a final wave, the hatch was closed again at 4:30 p.m. Central Time.
The KVDBO S2 indicator S4 is not eliminated, it's not on. Okay, we copy.
I am several hatches involved in this process. You're looking basically at Sergei Volkov working on the Poisk module side of the docking interface, and there's Mike Fossum.
Monitoring the pressure. Please open the display. Preparing the S2, okay, it's prepared, monitoring the display in the SKGS. Okay, copy. Okay, no later than...
Although you're not hearing any audio at the moment, based on the configuration that the crew is downlinking this video in, Mike Fossum is essentially explaining the process of closing the hatch between the Poisk module and the Russian segment of the International Space Station and the Soyuz spacecraft. Behind that hatch, Ron Garin, Alexander Samokutyayev, and Andrei Borisenko, and the process of checking out the Soyuz systems. The Soyuz now on autonomous internal battery power, as well as the crew in the Soyuz soon to begin the process of suiting up in their Sokol launch and entry suits and conducting a series of leak checks to ensure that an airtight seal exists between the Soyuz and the Poisk prior to the command that will be sent at 7:35 p.m. Central Time to begin a 3-minute process of driving hooks and latches open that have held the Soyuz firmly in place to the Poisk module since April 7th. Springs on either side of the docking interface then will push off against one another, and physical separation will occur at 7:38 p.m. Central Time.
Дальше делаем. Сейчас сбросит 25.
Угу.